Everybody, thank you for joining WOC Facebook Live this evening. I pray that you guys were blessed and had a good day today. I had an awesome day today, and the presence of the Lord has been awesome, 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 awesome. So I'm glad to have you guys join in on today. I got a word from the Lord. It's always good when you get a word from the Lord. And last week, we dealt with the matters of the heart, things about the heart the Lord wanted to talk about, because he wanted to clean the heart for what he's about to do. And he wanted to make sure that you got the clean heart principle, that you can jump in and get what he's about to release and what he is releasing. He actually started the release. So let's go ahead and pray real quick. Let's go to the throne room of grace. Father, we give you glory, praise, and honor. We magnify your name and we exalt you, God, for you are God and God alone. We thank you for our online Bible study, Father God, and we just ask that you be in the midst. I ask you, Father God, that you would touch the hearts and minds of your every hearer that's on this live, Father God, that the word would speak life unto them, Father God. I thank you for downloads, revelation, and knowledge, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Now, Holy Spirit, we ask that you lead this Bible study. We ask that you teach teach the Bible study, for you're the greatest teacher that there is. As I open my mouth, you promised me that you would fill it. So I ask to hear none of me, but all of you. I thank you for a right now word, God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. 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 So I got a word today, y'all. I got a good word today. In the word today, my topic is there's a harvest in the famine. So we know that there's a famine going on, and I'm here to tell you there's some other things that are brewing. There's some other things that's going to come that is not going to be good. Okay. But there's another thing that's coming after the COVID-19. There's some things brewing. But the good thing is he always take care of the saints. The good thing is the saints can always be in the middle of something, and there's a hedge around us. So it's a good time for some, and some it won't be a good time. But those that are part of the kingdom of God, this is your time. This is your time. I can't express this enough. I've been preaching and teaching on this a lot because the dealings of the Lord has been upon me for this, and I've been getting confirmation. I've been hearing other people saying it, so we're picking up in the same vein. And not only that, I'm not a prosperity preacher at all. I am definitely a deliverance preacher, teacher. No matter what, at the end of the day, I can start off one way, and I'm always going to come back to deliverance, because that's what's in me. That's who I am. That's my anointing. But God has given me a word, and he's been dealing with me with prosperity, even in the midst of the famine. So there is a famine that's hitting the earth, but guess what? It's a time to thrive for the saints of God. So I want to draw your attention on some things that you're going to see taking place. I don't know if you heard some people say it, and I have said it myself. When this stuff started happening, I said, we're about to find out who's who. Because one thing about it is tribulation. When tribulation comes, if the heat of the fire comes, people tend you to show you who they are. What's in them comes out of them. And you begin to know who was who. And I promise you, this is going to be the time where we're going to find out who was who, because only the strongest going to survive. Only those that are really, really anchored in the Lord are going to survive. We're about to find out who was in God for his hand and who was in God for his face. And those that really just, I gave my life up to God. I gave everything to God. And no matter what comes my way, no matter what happens, those are the ones that are remaining. But those ones that says, I'm running to God because I'm in trouble, I need God's help. You know, they think he's a part-time God. Oh, I need God to bless me. I need God to give me this. I need God to give me that. And all that. Those who like to use God, they're not going to survive. And what God is releasing ain't for them. It's for the faithful. It's for the righteous. It's for the remnant. And be so glad that you are the remnant. So guess what? It's harvest time. There is a harvest in the famine. And this is what you're going to see what the Lord is doing. I want to draw your attention to Matthew chapter 13, verse 24 through 30. I want to draw your attention here. And it says, another parable put he forth unto them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is likened unto a man which have sown good seeds in the field. But while men slept, his enemies came and sowed tares among the wheat and went his way. But when the blade was sprung up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tares also. So the servants of the householder came and said unto him, sir, didst not thou sow good seed in the field? From which then have it tares? He said unto them, an enemy have done this. And the servants said unto him, will thou then that thou will go and gather them up? And he said, nah. Least while you gather up the tares, you root up also the wheat with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. And in the time of the harvest, I will say to the reapers, gather together first the tares and bind them in bundles to burn them. But I want to stick with verse 30. First thing he said, let them both grow together until the harvest. And in the time of the harvest, I will say to the reapers, gather ye together first the tares. Guess what? It's harvest time. So now that it's harvest time, there is a separating from the wheat and the tare. The tare is the worldly Christians, and the wheat are the Christian, the kingdom Christians. And so God says, burn them up, get them all together. And then he says, unto the wheat, put them in my barn, in God's barn. So what is he doing? He's putting you into his barn that is filled with plentiful things for you. So this is the season where you're going to see this separating. You're going to say, oh, they fell by the wayside. They just fallen by the wayside. I thought they was in God. They were in God as long as they were benefiting from his hand. But now they're not seeing the hand of God move because there's a famine in the land and God is doing a separating. And so in this, those that you saw start off with you and that you saw they might have been your dancing partner, you might not see them no more. Because one thing about it is when they grow together, the reaper couldn't tell who they were at first because they look alike. So the wheat and the tare look alike before they grew. So you couldn't really tell them apart. So he was like, you can't uproot the tare because you might grab the wheat because you can't tell them apart because they look alike. But as they grow, you'll find out who they are. And that's what God was getting that heart clean, because that heart is going to show you who they are, right? So he said you had to wait until they grow. And then we go in before harvest time, because when it's time to harvest, we can't have anything growing in our fields that can kill the wheat. So God is saying, I'm separating the wheat from the tare. And I'm going to tell you this. Those that sought the hand of God, they ask God for blessings after blessings, and they never attempt to change their lives. They wanted to be able to serve God and serve the world. They're called worldly Christians. Sometimes they have come to church, and a lot of times when you see them come to church, like Easter, Christmas, special holidays, or if hell hit their house, they will beat down the church. And they would be the one like this, God, I need you. And they only want him for a moment. And they'd be like, yeah, I'm wrong. They'll confess everything. They'll do everything you're supposed to, just like as someone that was truly repenting. You'll see them both at the altar. You'll see the wheat and tare at the altar. And they both are crying out to God, right? But the tare is only crying out. And he's sounding like the wheat. It sounds like true repentance, but it's false repentance, because they're going to go back and do what they did before. They're just trying to play God as if God don't already know. So they're going to sit there and say, oh, I'm so sorry, I won't do this no more. Knowing good and well, the minute that they bring him out, they go right back to doing what they were doing, and you don't see them in church no more. Do you know what I'm talking about? This is called the worldly Christians. Then you got some of the worldly Christians that are faithful. They like being in church because they like being a part of something. And so some people like church, like to be a social club to them, or a social thing, but church is not a social club. Church is a place of learning and training. And so some of them go to church because their friends go to church, or they can't fit in nowhere else, so they just go to church and all they want is they want God to bless me, but they remain in sin and nothing changes in their life. They're called the worldly Christians. Nothing changes in their life. They sit in church Sunday after church. They will be faithful to every Bible study, every prayer, and every Sunday morning, and nothing changes in their life. They still remain the same mindset. They still operate in the same old things. These are worldly Christians. So if you find that to be you, true repentance is your portion, because God is doing a separating, I'm telling you. And right now, God is not going to allow the righteous saints to suffer with the worldly saints. There comes a time that we divide. There's a time there's a dividing. And some people say, oh, that's not fair. That's not just, it's biblical. It's the word. And the word of God is true. And there's benefits to the righteous. So I want to speak to you today and let you know, the Bible says, you know, don't be envious of the ways. So let me take you to Psalms 37. Because this is where the true believers get stuck at. So I'm going to take you to Psalms 37, and we're going to go from 1 through 11. I don't know if I want to read the whole thing, but I don't know if I'm going to, where's that? Psalms 37. 37. Why do I have? Oh, yeah. Okay. So Psalms 37. Let me get there real quick. And this is where I hear a lot of Christians, and this is where the Christians get stuck at. Because you know why the Christians get stuck here? They look at the world prospering in their face, and they're saying, well, I serve God, so I should be on top. But that's not what the Word of God says, right? And so a lot of the saints get little distraught because they see the wicked prospering, but that's only for a season. That's only for a timing. That and they're prospering off of the wicked. The enemy always pay his people. And so if they serve him, he said, I'll pay you. Look what he told Jesus. He says, if you will bow down and worship me, I'll give you all of this. Like telling Jesus, I'll give you the world if you will bow down and worship me, if you will serve me. This is what I give to you. And Jesus knew better because the earth is his and the fullness thereof. So Satan couldn't give him what he already owned. He came back to claim back which was already his. And so now as the saints don't know their rights in God, so they sell out. They sell out. The enemy said, if you serve me, I'm going to give you this. I'm going to make this easy for you, where it looks harder for the saints, because guess what? They're not yielding to the things of the world. And so it looks like the world is prospering over them. And the Lord says, we get stuck in that area, and he don't want you stuck in the area looking at the wicked because they're prospering just now. But the switch is coming. So yeah, they was prospering. Yeah, you was watching them. Yeah, you were saying, oh my gosh, so many doors are open for them. Oh my gosh, they get the best jobs. Oh my gosh, they got the best houses. They got husbands. And here I am single and I ain't got no husband. They got the best marriages. Everything that glimmer, that looks good, ain't good. Everything glimmer ain't gold, right? So you only see what they allow you to see on the outside, right? And so the Lord says the switch is coming, right? Because so now we know that we already heard over and over, over and over that the wealth of the wicked is laid out for the just. Now, I don't know if you're tired of hearing that, but I ain't tired of hearing that because I'm walking in the manifestation of it. And if you know what I know, you will be hashtagging that wealth of the wicked is finding me now. The wealth of the wicked is finding me now. It's finding me now. It's finding me now because it belongs to us. Amen. Why? Because we're children of the Most High God. He said the earth is his and the fullness thereof. Right. So everything that belongs to Jesus belongs to us. That is our benefit. It's our inheritance. Right. So I want to take you somewhere here. And it says, fret not thyself. And this is Psalms 37 and 1. It says, fret not thyself of evildoers, neither be envious against the workers of iniquity. Don't be envious of those who are in sin. Because they're in sin don't mean that just because they look like they're prospering don't mean that they're in right standing with God. And I don't care if they're saints. And I had a young lady said to me, like, you know, Pastor, I'm living holy. And then we got another sister, she ain't living holy, and she's booed up with her for her boyfriend, and I'm talking to her on the phone, and she's booed up. Well, that's her, right? But at the end of the day, don't you get caught with your hands dirty, because the Bible says no man know the day nor the hour that the Son of Man shall appear. So she might be joined now, because see, sin is fun. But when they open the eyes of hell, it ain't fun no more, right? So don't be envious of the ways and how they get their money and the things they do. And guess what? And I'm also going to drop this bomb on you. Those of you that walk up right before God, those of you that are Christians, those of you are the redeemed, you should not be looking for drug dealers to be your boyfriend. How can two walk together except they agree? You love money more than you love God. When God said the earth is his, the fullness thereof, that money runs out sooner or later. It ends one way or another, but the benefits of the Lord remain forever. Hallelujah. Then we wonder why God don't give us it. Because, you know, I'm not going to go there. Let's go back over here. So for verse 2, they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herb. The Bible says that comes to naught in a season. Don't try to be like something that's going to come to an end. It's not going to last forever. But what God has for you, it lasts forever, forever. Trust in the Lord and do good. So you do opposite than what they're doing. Trust in the Lord and do good, right? And so shall they dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. He said, you will be fed if you do good. You will be fed if you do good. Verse 4 says, delight thyself in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart, if you delight yourself in God and not the world. Now, wait a minute, because I got something for you guys today. Amen. Commit thy ways unto the Lord. Trust also in him and he shall bring it to pass. So everything that you are wanting God to bring it to pass and you commit your ways unto the Lord, he said, guess what he said? I will bring it to pass, right? Because it said, if you walk up right before me, no good thing will I withhold from you. Don't you know the word of God is true and it cannot lie? And if God, if you committed your ways unto the Lord and the Lord did not bring it to pass, that will make him a liar. But we know that God is not a liar, right? We know that heaven and earth shall pass away and his word shall stand. So let's go a little further here. I want to take you to Psalms 67, 5 and 7. Wait a minute, I'm almost there. Psalm 67, okay, 5 and 7. I didn't mark that one either, you guys. Where am I at? Psalm 67, 5 and 7. Let the people praise thee, O Lord God. Let all the people praise thee. Then shall the earth yield her increase, and God, even our own God, shall bless us. Wait, starts with a praise. In the midst of everything, while you're committing yourself unto the Lord and you don't see nothing moving, you start blessing God. He said, let all the people praise thee. All the people. And when you praise them, then the earth will yield its fruit. So guess what? There's increase coming to you that the earth is going to yield into your barns. God says, put them in my barns. So when you're in the barns of the Lord, there's an overflow in increase that comes to you. And let me tell you this, when he separate the wheat and tare, and they're not going to get what you're getting, don't you bless what God has already called cursed. So don't give out your blessings, because guess what? It's going to dry up your land, and they can call you stingy. They can call what you want, but God is going to bless you, and you are not to give which is holy unto the dogs. Hello, somebody. You can't ask God to give you blessings and you're feeding it to worldly people. Right now, this is not the time. Now, there's going to be a gathering of souls, and the sinners are going to come in. They're going to repent, and they're going to turn their lives to God. That's different. But those that you know been straddling the fence for years and years and years and playing with the hand of God, God is smacking that out the way. So don't you put your hands and touch it. They're going to be going through trials and tribulation, and they're going to be looking for everywhere to find help, and they're not going to find them because they did not make Jesus Lord. They said it out of their mouth, but they didn't do it in their hearts. And it's a difference, because when Jesus is Lord, that means he rules. That means that he's the ruler over your life. That means he's in control of your life. And that means that you acknowledge him in all your ways. That means that you make no decisions without him. That means that you seek him. You pray to him. You live the life. You don't just halfway live the life. Amen. Amen. Glad you guys are still with me. So I want to go a little bit further over here. I want to take you now to Psalms 37. Because in Psalms 37, it talks about 17 commandments that God commanded us to do. And I'm going to talk about seven of them. And then it's talked about 25 promises that he'll give if you do the commandments. One thing about God is he always requires something of you, and then he do, right? He doesn't just do and you just sit there and do nothing. He make you take the first step, right? He says, if you draw nigh to me, then I'll draw nigh to you. But he says, if you want me closer, there's things that you got to do to bring me closer, right? So if you draw nigh to me, I draw nigh to you, right? And so he says, if you praise me, then the earth will yield its increase. So he's saying over and over, there's something you must do in order to move my hand in the direction that you needed to move in. So if he tell us, and that he gave us seven commands that he don't want us to fret, right? He says, don't be envious of evildoers. He told us to trust in him. So there's things that we got to do before we even see the benefits of the Lord coming to pass in our lives, right? He said, delight yourself in me. That means get happy in God. Don't walk around sorrowful and always got your face down because you don't see nothing moving yet, right? So let me tell you something. Never, ever, ever, ever go by anything God, anything looks like, because things change at the twinkling of an eye. Things change just like this, right? So I'm going to tell you this. I've been doing this 30-day decree, and I'm going to get back to these seven. I've been doing this 30-day decree, and I had a lot of people are doing it with me. And in this decree, I am getting emails every single day from different people of their testimonies since they started this decree. We are on, 10 days? We're getting ready to go on 11 days come tomorrow. And we already got testimonies after testimonies. Things changed overnight. They didn't see it coming, but they started using what was in their mouth. And life was in their mouth. And as they'd been decreeing it, they would come to pass. I got one email today, and that email said, I've been waiting on God for years. I have been praying for God for years. And the minute I started decreeing, I have seen it come to pass and manifest, and I was able to check it off my list. And I've been praying for years. Sometimes you ain't got to pray. All you got to do is speak. And there's some things you do got to pray about, but he's giving you the authority to call things that be not as though they were. He's giving you the authority to call things in your life. So whatever you need in your life, you can call it in. So needless to say, I said all that to say to you, delight yourself in the Lord. And that's what you do. I get excited in my decree. My decree ran out of my belly today like a river. And I felt my spirit enlarged, and I got super excited, and I did not see no manifestation. I saw one manifestation so far since I started decreeing. I can testify that yes, I saw one manifestation, but what I was decreeing today, I didn't see no manifestation for, and I felt enlarged in my spirit, and I started delighting myself in God. I got excited as if I already seen it. I started praising God as if I already seen it, because one thing I know is that God is not a liar, nor is his word. So you have to apply the principle. Somebody say it's the principle thing. Go ahead, put it in your comment, hashtag it. It's the principle thing. And so, and that in it, I learned to bless the Lord at all times. I learned to praise God at all times. And he says, when we begin to praise him, the earth is going to yield her fruit to us. When we begin to praise him, the blessings of the Lord are going to find us. Amen. Okay. So let's go a little further. So delight thyself. That was number four. Number five, commit your ways unto the Lord, not unto the world. See, once you got saved, you are born again. Your mind's supposed to be renewed. So that means you're not supposed to be still you in church 2 to 3 years and you still doing stuff that you was doing in the world. You didn't commit your ways unto the Lord. You are a fence straddler. And God says that you're either be hot or cold, or I will spew you out of my mouth. So don't think you're good because you go to church. Don't think you good because you dance, gave tithe and offering. You ain't good. He says, I want you either way. I would rather you to be all the way in the world cold than being in my face, being a perpetrator. He said, I can't stand phony nor fake. He said, you know what I do? I spew you out of my mouth. He said, you either be hot or cold. So you make your mind up. Are you hot? Are you hot for God? Are you on fire for God? Did you commit your ways? Do you live your life for God? And guess what? That means some people got to fall off, right? That means some music got to change. That means that when I look at you, I ought to see a difference in your dressing. I mean, there's something that should say something about you should say something changed. I shouldn't see darkness on you. I should see the glory. Why? What is that glow that I see on the inside of you? There's something about you that is different. Your communication is not even the same. You can't even listen to the music that you used to listen to. So let me tell you this. If you are still in this place, you have not committed your ways unto the Lord. Now you might have a heart that wants to serve God, but honey, there's times that you got to do more than just want it. You got to do it, right? So then that's your place of repentance. God, forgive me. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Forgive me. And see, listen, God will help you. God will help you. Now, let me tell you, he give grace where grace is needed. And grace is there for our oops. God, I felt I made a mistake. But grace is not a lifestyle of sin, nor is it the license to sin. Okay? I'm going to say this is my favorite thing to say, and you hear it all the time. God knows my heart. Yup, is deceitful and wicked, and who can know it but God? Get delivered from that, okay? Because when you say God knows my heart, yeah, he knows your heart. He said it's deceitful. It will lie to God. It will try to deceive God. Sometimes we sit up in church, and we want to plead with God, and we tell lies. And you know how I know that's true? Because God had me do a sermon about people making pledges to them that they didn't keep. They promised God, if you do this, God, I'm going to do this. If you do this, God, I'm going to give this. And if this happened, God, I'm going to give this. And God did everything that they asked him to do, and they never came back and gave God what they promised they was going to give God. So they lied to God. They lied to him, and they did not have a fear with lying to the Lord. And so I want to make sure that you are in right standing to get this wealth transfer that's coming to the righteous. Now, you can't get mad at somebody who is prospering, and if they're your friend and they're prospering over you, don't let that ugly head of jealousy pop out at you and you got so much to say. What you should do is examine yourself and say, God, why am I not receiving what you have for me? Not what my sister have, because I don't want everything she has. I don't want her house. I don't want her car. I don't want her finances. I don't want her husband, her fiance, whoever. I don't want her life. I want to prosper in what you have for me. But why am I not prospering? The Bible says, let a man examine himself, right? So sometimes we got to examine ourselves, because he said, if we walk up right before him, no good thing will he withhold us. And then he said, I'm no respecter of person. I'm not just going to bless someone over you. I'm not going to do that. But I treat my kids accordingly to how they live their lives. Now, I'm going to tell you this. I have 4 children. And I treat them accordingly to the maturity level, to their character, because you know your kids, right? So I gave one of my kids, I put them on my credit card. They got a whole bunch of credit line on it. And I don't even worry. Gave them a card in their name for emergency, but I would not give it to the others because I know their character, right? So that's just like the father. He will test you. He will prove you. And he knows your character. So he knows what he can trust you with that you're not going to be crazy with. And he knows that whatever he gives you, that you'll be true to it. And that you won't be just lying in his face just to get it. He knows these things. He knows these things, right? Okay, so let's go on a little bit further. It says rest in him. That's the problem we have, because we want everything to happen right away. We can't rest in God. God wants us to rest in him. When you rest in God, oh my gosh, peace finds your life. Peace finds your life. Anxiety will have no place in your life if you rest in him. If you don't know how to, you tell God, God, I don't know how to rest in you. I need you to help me. I need you to show me how to rest in you. God, give me the spirit of rest. Honey, he will give it to you. If you don't see it right away, guess what you do? You keep asking him until it manifests. The problem is we like to give up too fast. We like to give up too fast. It ain't working. We cancel stuff out. God said, I'm trying to get you to a blessed place. I'm trying to get you to a blessed place. Some of you guys, I'm telling you, are going to come into wealth that's going to bless your businesses. And some of you have never even started your businesses, but you're going to start businesses. And I'm telling you, it's the turnaround now. Things are coming to the kingdom. So some of the people who have business in the world are going to fold. But those that are in the kingdom, you're going to rise up and take their places. Get ready to catch the wealth transfer that's going to come to you. But let me tell you this, let nothing stop you, because it's coming to the righteous. And make sure you are the one that's getting it. You are not the fence straddler. You're the one who get it. Does he love the fence straddle? Yes, he does. Will he answer their cries? At times he will, but there's a difference. Now, we're not beating up the fence straddles, but it's, come on, let's get it right. Now, if you say, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, Pastor, oh, this me, I don't want to be left behind. All you do, got to repent for real. Repent for real. Repent means turn away from. I'm not going back to it. You see, the thing about it, this is where people really don't understand what repentance is. They'll come and say, I'm repenting, knowing you're going right back to it. That's not repentance. You might as well ask God to forgive you. Forgive me, God. Forgive me. Right? But he'll forgive you. But guess what? It doesn't open you up to the benefits. Now, repentance, I turn away, God, I messed up. I fell short. The Bible says a righteous man adjustment, fall 7 times, he gets back up again. So none of us, you know, are perfect or anything like that. But the thing is that our hearts in God is perfect and we strive to please God. You know, Paul said, when I would do good, evil will always be present. You know, the enemy is always going to present himself to you. He's always going to test you. But you got to be strong enough with enough integrity that for God I live, for God I die. I'm not yielding to this. Now, is it going to present itself to you? Yes, it is. But you got to be strong enough to walk away. And you got to have a made up mind. For God I live, for God I die. For God I live, for God I die. And you got to have the point is that I serve God not because he going to take care of me. He going to do that automatically. Not because he going to give me this. Not because I can rub a thing like a genie. What's the thing called? The genie lamp. He's not a genie. I want to make a wish. Oh, genie, give me. No, that's not God. And so God wants you to love him and want to know more about him. Learn about the things of God. Learn about his characteristics. Learn about glory. Learn about heaven. Learn the word of God. Let it get in you. Show you the power of the word. Show you what the word will do for you. He wants you to be like that. He wants you to study the word. He wants you to read the word. He just don't want you to put it on a shelf and to pick it up when you're in trouble. That's not for you. So moving right along. Y'all still with me? Y'all still with me? Okay. So you have 25 promises. And all this is in the book of Proverbs 37. I just don't have time to go over all of them with you. And so what I want to do, I'm dealing with the number 7 tonight, because the number 7 is the number of perfection. And he's calling perfection in our life, right? So God is getting ready to perfect some things that concerns you. I promise you, he's perfecting. This is the hour that we've been waiting on. We have been waiting on God to move in our life. We have been standing still, but now it's time to see the manifestation of the things that we prayed for. It's here. I'm not talking about it's going to happen. I'm telling you, it's here. It's dropping on our laps. Okay? It's here. And so I want to take you down to 7 things that he promised. 7 things of the promises. 1, you would dwell in the land forever. Forever. That means there's no uprooting you. You ain't going nowhere. You would dwell in the land. Amen? He will feed you. You will be fed and no lack will come nigh to your dwelling place. If there's a famine in the land, there is a raven that's assigned to your life, because he is going to feed you. He's going to feed you. God will command people to take care of you. He's done it for me. I'm telling you the truth. And they didn't even know they was commanded by God. They was just doing things out of the heart. And he said to me, they are your ravens this season. I have commanded them to feed you. And they did just that for a season. I'm telling you. So when I went through a hardship, I never missed a beat. Never missed a beat, because he had ravens ready to feed me. And God says, if there's a famine in the land, there is a raven appointed to your life that will feed you. God will feed you through the supernatural. So you'll never have to worry about that. 3. He give you the desire of your heart. We heard that when we read that, right? The desire of your heart. He said he would give it unto you. 4, he will bring things to pass. We heard that when we read the scripture. 5, bring the righteousness to light. Ain't that something? He didn't say bring the people, the church going people. He said the righteous. Bring judgment as the noonday. 7, evildoers will be cut off. Those that plot evil against you. Those that work treacherously behind your back. That try to block you. Try to stop you. Try to hinder things. They will be cut off. And he will fight all of your battles. There's nothing that you will have to do. He will fight the battles. Now, you have to find rest in the commandments. And the rest in the promises of God. For them to happen, you have to rest in him. Follow his commandments and you will see these things happen for you. You will see them happen. God's no respecter person. So if you see God moving miraculously in someone's life, don't you ever think that it won't happen for you. And that's the lie the enemy tell you. Oh, God's favor upon them. Oh, God love them. God's going to get to them, but he's not going to. No, he said, I'm no respecter of a person. If you're willing to do what they did, then you can get what they're getting. But you have to do what they do. So some things people do, some things people give up, some things people sacrifice to get to just for the Lord. And they do it from the heart, not asking God for anything. And he gives them overflow. I'm telling you, never ever have I seen the righteous forsaken nor his seed begging for bread. That is true. And that's a testimony in my life. I have seen the supernatural things of God. I'm currently writing a book on all the supernatural things that I've seen God do in my life. So my church kind of knows a lot of my stories. I've seen God move miraculously in my life. I have like wow stories in my life. And so God, the supernatural, wants to visit your house. And the God of the supernatural wants to visit your house. And people say, oh, you're talking that supernatural spooky stuff. Why is supernatural spooky to you? And why is not common to you as a Christian? Because God is supernatural. And if we get out of the natural and we'll operate more in the supernatural, then maybe our lives will be a little bit better. So I want to take you a little further. Another thing is when I want to take you back to this. I forgot this part. He says, do not be envious of the evil doers. One thing about God, if you're envious of the evil doers, he can't give you the desires of your heart. Because that means what you're wanting in your heart is from the wicked. You don't want it from the evil one. You want it from God. So don't be envious of them. Their stuff be cut off. They will prosper for a season, but you will prosper forever. Let's do the math. Season, forever. Which one you want? Season, forever. Right? You will prosper. There's a wealth transfer coming, and it's called supernatural. And this is the thing. You know how they say when you go up, the same people you see when you come back down? Be careful how you treat people, because some people have stepped on you on the way up. They get ready to come down and face you and watch you take their place as you go up. So when you're going up, make sure that you still treat people equal and that you don't think you're better than them and treat them differently, because tables turn. And that's what people fail to realize. Tables turn, they flip. So be careful how you treat people. So when God is blessing you going up, don't get so high-minded, so big-headed that you forget that you was once in their shoes too, that you forget who you are and lose your mind. And guess what? You're not going to be a celebrity. God is not giving you a celebrity lifestyle. Get rid of that garbage. That's of the world. So don't get big-headed because he blesses you. And then you want to act like a celebrity and treat people like they're dirt. Ain't no God in that. Because you might meet that same person coming back down. Just like the person that did that to you, they get ready to meet you on the way down while you're going up. Because there is a transfer going on. It's shifting. Okay, so let me take you to Psalms 103, 1 through 2. Psalms 103, 1 through 2. Wait a minute. Psalms 103, 1 through 2. Okay. So, bless the Lord, all my soul, and all that's within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, all my soul, and forget not all his benefits. So one thing we saw again, bless the Lord. Guess what? Bless the Lord. Guess what? Bless the Lord and get the benefits. Bless the Lord at all times. I say it all the time. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise will continually be in my mouth. You know why I do that? Y'all just don't know. The worst times of my life, I will bless the Lord and still have a praise. And it will keep my mind. My praise would keep my mind. There was times that I thought I was going to have a nervous breakdown. And I was praising God. And he said, let the mind of Christ be also in you. And I can hear him. And he said, I strengthen your mind. And my mind was strengthened, you guys. And then people's looking at me like, girl, I know your story, but you got joy. They were like confused. They were so confused. They would say, well, I had one person said to me, I was waiting for you to break down. I was waiting to see your sorrow. And I never seen it because I was anchored in God. And I had a praise in my lips, so they couldn't see what they was waiting to see because of my situation would cause anyone to want to have a breakdown, anyone to be depressed. But the joy of the Lord was my strength, because even in the midst of it, my praise brought me joy, and I was able to see beyond what I was seeing. When I would praise God, I wasn't seeing my current situation. I would see me coming out. I would see me exiting out of Egypt. And don't you know that I came out of Egypt? And when I came out of Egypt, you know what God did? He lifted up the staff and caused me to walk on dry ground. He gave me that miracle. So I'm telling you, bless the Lord at all times, and it will cause the blessings of the Lord to come in your life. And it says, and then look what it says. Bless the Lord, all my soul, and forget not all his benefits, right? So sometimes you got to bless him and thank him for the benefits. And when you look at the Message Bible, it says, don't forget not one of his benefits, not one of them. Don't forget not one. So there's so many benefits to the Lord just because you're in him. There's benefits because of who you are in him. These benefits are going to find you and I'm telling you, and run you over. Right now, you got stuff that's looking for you. I'm telling you now, you got things that are looking for you because it's already been released off the wicked and it's floating in the atmosphere and is looking to find you. Tell you the truth. Call it forth. Call it forth. Call it forth. Here I am. Find me now. Here I am. Find me now. You need peace? Peace. Here I am. Find me now. Whatever you need. Here I am. Find me now. Right? You got things that are looking for you. Are you willing to receive them? Because some of the things that God has looking for you is going to blow your mind. It's going to blow your mind. Now, God says, I wish above all things that you prosper and be in health, even as your soul shall prosper. So I want you to prosper in the natural, and I want you to prosper in the spirit, and I want you to prosper in your health. He said, that's my will. It is your will. It is his will to bless you. And it's time for you to be blessed as the saints of God. It's time for you to be blessed. But I'm telling you, that heart got to be clean, a pure heart. Got to be clean, because that's who the angels are looking for. Those who have clean hands and a pure heart. They're looking for those. When you lift your hands and the hands are clean, the angels are who? They're going to righteous. Because see, your hands tell your story, right? So some people lift up their hands look black as coal, dirty. Some people look at their hands, they be white or like fire, red like fire. And the angels can identify you when you lift up your hands. And when your hands lifted up, there can be a drop, a release coming. I'm going to tell you what happened to me today too. What happened to me today, I don't know if I should release that, but what happened to me today is get ready to change my life forever. Seriously. And it was prophesied to me last night, yesterday, from an apostle. He prophesied to me last night. And I said, oh, so when he prophesied it to me, he found me. I haven't talked to him in so long. He called someone to get in touch with me. And he says, I need to find Apostle Don Marva. And so he did. And when he did, he prayed for me. He released what the Lord was saying to me. And one thing he had released unto me, I won't tell you what it is, because I'll let you know when I walk in it, when it's tangible in my hands. So he released this word to me. And I thought, praise God, because this is what I've been wanting to do. And I was getting ready to pursue it. But what I didn't know, that it was going to happen overnight. So today, I got another call. And that call, it says, I got connections for this, 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 and this. And I can plug you in. It was just prophesied last night. And today, they said they'll plug me in. And guess what it would? It would be sitting on top of the world. I'm back in Eden. With all provisions sitting on top of the world. And guess what? Don't feel guilty when God bless you, because you were called to be blessed. Don't you know when Adam and Eve was in the garden, it was prosperous. It was plentiful. There was no lack, no want. They had more than enough. And so it shall be. He said, I came back to restore that which was lost, which was taken away. Jesus came back and he said, I want you back in Eden. And I'm going to be back in Eden. And in Eden, they were sitting what? On top of the world. Donna Lawrence to sing that song. Go back to Eden, sitting on top of the world. Why? Because we're called to rule, to possess. Amen. He said, the earth I've given unto man, right? So why not sit on top of it? Possess that what God has given to us. It's coming back into our hands. And when you get blessed by God, make sure that you're still serving from your heart. Make sure you're still dedicated. Make sure you're still committed, because it's going to, if you're not, it's going to leak a hole and it's going to run out of you quickly. And you're going to find yourself in a state that you was in the last time, because God is never going to let you use them. Amen. Amen. So I want to take you to two more scriptures and then I'll be done. Okay. I hope you guys are getting something today, but I'm super excited and super blessed. And I release that super Satan on you and that blessing on you, that you're going to be blessed and you're going to walk in the wealthy places of God, in your health and your mental state and your finances. And you're going to walk in it. And I call your family hold. I call your family hold in Jesus' name. Listen, I can't stop decreeing. I've been decreeing so much. Every time I talk to people, they say, I said, decree that in your life. Oh, what? I decree that in your life. Why? Because I believe in the words that I speak out of my mouth. And so should you. I've seen the manifestations, and it's different when you see manifestations. Let me take you to Proverbs 3:9-10. Honor the Lord with your substance and with the first fruit of all thy increase. So shall thy barns be filled with plenty, and thy presses shall be burst out with new wine. So shall thy barns be filled with plenty. Joseph knew about this. There was a famine in the land, but there was a wealth transfer, and Joseph walked in it. There was a harvest. There is a harvest in the midst of the famine. You'll see some in famine, but there's some that's going to be in harvest. Okay, so Deuteronomy 28:8. Okay. Almost done. You guys been blessed so far? If so, hearts. I'll see the hearts later. But if you've been blessed so far, hearts, say, I'm blessed. I'm blessed in the city. I'm blessed in the field. I'm blessed in my coming in. I'm blessed in my going out. I'm blessed. You know, I would attempt to sing it, you know, but I've learned. Don't tempt this thing. Stay in your own lane. Because I would feel like singing. I'm blessed in the city. Oh, my gosh. Okay, so moving right along. Deuteronomy 28:8. The Lord shall command. Somebody said, command them blessings on me, God. The Lord shall command the blessings upon the in thy storehouse, your barn, that's plenty in your storehouses, and in all that set thy hand unto, and shall bless thee in the land which the Lord thy God giveth. What? Did you say you'll command a blessing on me, God? What? He said, I command. God command his promises and his blessings to be upon all those that belong to you and to him, and everything that you undertake. When God commands his blessings upon you and all that you possess, that's what he's going to do. Everything that you possess, he's going to call a blessing unto it. That means your children. That means your family. That means your household. That means your jobs. That means your businesses. That means your health. Everything you set your hands to do, God says, I command a blessing. So I pray that you receive the word today. And know that God command a blessing to find you. I told you there's things out there looking for you because he commanded it to come to you. He commanded it to come to you. Listen, those of you that were getting no's, you're getting ready to turn around and get yeses. And you're it's going to blow your mind because you're going to say, I'm telling you, those of you that got jobs that you're not qualified, you're going to get. God's going to give you favor. You might know the work, but you don't have the degree. You're going to get the job and you're going to get paid as if you had the degree. I'm telling you, supernatural wealth and favor is finding you today. And I promise you, if I was you, I would not dip out of the hands of the Lord. I would not backslide. This ain't the hour nor the time for backsliding. And just because you ain't in church, you shouldn't be backsliding, because that goes to say that you were only in church to get his hand. Because when you are rooted in God, even if you're not in church around the saints, you are committed to the Lord. You're committed to the Lord. We might not be together in church, but at the same time, it don't change our stand with God. So don't go to church for people or the pastor. Go because this is your feeding place, that this is the house of the Lord. And so because you're not in the house of the Lord, you feed this house, that this house may be strong. This house may be growing. This ain't the time to throw in the towel, to give up. You're going to miss everything that you waited for. Everything you pray for is going to slip out your hands. Everything. You don't lose. Now is not the time. It looks really bad, but honey, this ain't the time. I've seen people prosperous in this season. People are getting houses in this season. People are getting promotions on their job this season. People are getting healed in this season. It looks like a bad time because we're in the world. But remember, we're in the world, but we're not of the world, right? Don't go by what it look like. Let me tell you, Sunday, he had me preach about the supernatural feedings. Once again, Elijah with the widow woman, he fed her supernaturally. He sent a man of God her way, just like he sent a raven. So God knows how to feed you, and he would do it supernaturally. He's the God of the supernatural. And if you got people around you that don't believe in the supernatural, or they downplay the supernatural, you better get them out of your life. I mean, stop telling them what God's going to do and all that, because what they're doing is they're hindering the move of God in your life. So get around those who can celebrate with you, those who can rejoice with you, those who can praise God with you. Even when they don't see it, they still praising God with you. So I pray that you were blessed, and I pray that you are ready for this supernatural transfer of wealth that's coming your way. Don't forget to pay your tithes and your offering. And some of you getting held back land, some land that's been held back, God's going to release it. You're going to get it. Money is going to find you. And I will tell you this. There's a man that I'm going to tell you this. Now, if God did it for him, let me tell you this. He gonna do it for you. People were seeking him out of state, trying to find him, because he got inheritance that he don't know nothing about. So they call all around to looking for him, because there's a blessing out there looking for him, trying to find him, because he got an inheritance he don't know nothing about. I'm gonna say to you once again, there's a blessing out there looking for you that's trying to find you. Because you got inheritance that you don't know nothing about. And our inheritance come from glory. This is our inheritance, comes from glory, and it's trying to find you. May the Lord bless you with your ministry. May the Lord bless you with your finances. May the Lord bless you in your health. May the Lord bless you in your business. May the Lord cause you to triumph. May the Lord bless you in your mental state. May the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Set you free. Deliver you from every struggle, and may he set you on high. And if you receive that today, it is your portion. May the Lord bless you real good. I pray you've been blessed. Thank you for joining me on live tonight. And I'm waiting to hear your testimonies. Just like I'm getting the testimonies from the challenges, they're coming in. They're flooding in. And so shall I get your testimony from this live video. And I pray that you would stand strong in the Lord, and that you serve him with your whole heart. Because God is looking for people who serve him from the heart. He's tired of being used. So don't be the user and the abuser to my Savior, to your Savior. He's looking to bless you, because it's his good pleasure to bless you. Amen. So I pray that you will bless on this live today. Once again, I love you. Thank you for tuning in. Have a blessed day. Let me pray for you real quick before we go. Father, I thank you for all the hearers that was on this live today, Father God, in the name of Jesus. You know what they stand in need of, Father God. You know every request they held up before you. I ask that you move in their life. I ask you that you open the door to the supernatural realm, Father God, that they can get the things and have access to the things they need without struggle. I frustrate the plans of enemy concerning their lives, Lord God. And I thank you now that the word has found them. I think that they will meditate on this word, Father God. I thank you that they will delight themselves in you over this word, Lord God. And I thank you that they will praise you. And that you, they will see you bring it to pass. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Have a blessed day.